Good morning.
Good morning.
We welcome you to worship here on the third Sunday in Advent, meaning it is the final week of preparation. And to help us prepare, our children have a program, a narrative of the Christmas story they will be sharing with us shortly. I want to welcome everyone, particularly those who are visiting with us, friends and family who might be joining in the celebration with us. We thank you for your presence here in worship. Several items, just so we're aware of the schedule of activities here at our church. This afternoon at 2 o'clock and at 4 o'clock are the preschool concerts. We'll also be presenting the story Bibles during those programs. If you have a question about that, or if you're one of the families who will be present to make that gift of a Bible, but you have a question, check with Bethany. She'll be able to help you. Next Sunday, in the morning, it is still Advent. One more candle when we get to lighting the wreath will be lit, the final fourth candle next Sunday in the morning service. There will not be an 11 a.m. service because later in the evening we have three services for Christmas Eve. There'll just be the one Sunday morning service at 9 a.m. No Sunday school or coffee hour, just the 9 a.m. service. Then at 5 p.m. will be our first Christmas Eve worship service. The praise team will be leading that, especially if in that service is a focus with our children. And then at 7 and 10 p.m., the traditional Christmas Eve services as well. All three of the services will be with candlelight. All three of the services will include Holy Communion. And then on Christmas Day is the annual Community Christmas Day dinner. We invite you to join us for dinner. If you're volunteering to help, want to lend a helping hand, great. But it's a wonderful celebration just to be with the community. Close to 1,000 people will probably flow through here that morning, the volunteers and those who enjoy the dinner. And we welcome you to be a part of that. So we gather today to connect with family, to unwrap gifts, and listen to the voices of excited children. Did I say excited children? Celebrating Christmas. It's what people do this time of year. A celebration today, however, is different. This is no ordinary family. We are brought together as the family of God. And the gifts unwrapped here may not be the ones on our wish list, but they're everything we ever wanted and needed. The children with us are excited because they get to share God's gifts with us. Therefore, with hope and anticipation, let us join our hearts and voices together and worship Jesus, the greatest gift of all. I invite you to stand as we sing the gathering song, O Come, O Ye Faithful. Light candles of the Advent wreath.
Christ is come. God is with us.
He is Emmanuel.
In the quiet of Advent waiting, let us pray. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, ruler of the universe. Your prophets spoke of a day when the desert would blossom and the waters would break forth in the wilderness. Bless us as we light the candles on the wreath. Strengthen our hearts as we prepare for the coming of the Lord. May he give water to all those who thirst, for he is our light and our salvation. Blessed be God forever. May the Lord who makes all things new come to us and give us peace.
First reading, Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 38, Jesus' birth foretold to Mary. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to the Galilean village of Nazareth to a virgin engaged to be married to a man descended from David. His name was Joseph, and the virgin's name Mary. Upon entering, Gabriel greeted her. "Good morning. You're beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you." She was thoroughly shaken, wondering what was behind a greeting like that. But the angel assured her, "Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You'll become pregnant and give birth to a son and call his name Jesus. He will be great, be called Son of the Highest. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will rule Jacob's house forever, no end ever to his kingdom." Mary said to the angel, "But how? I've never slept with a man." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The power of the Highest hover over you. Therefore, the child you bring to birth will be called Holy Son of God. And did you know that your cousin Elizabeth conceived a son, old as she is? Everyone called her barren. And here she is, 6 months pregnant. Nothing you see is impossible with God." And Mary said, "Yes, I see it all now. I am the Lord's maid, ready to serve. Let it be with me, just as you say." Then the angel left her.
So, how did Mary find out she was going to have a baby?
Oh, by an angel. The star? The star?
Angels?
Angels?
Because the angels told her.
An angel appeared to her and told her.
By an angel?
And what did the angel say to her, do you think?
That you're going to have a baby and his name's going to be Jesus.
That you're going to have a baby, blah, blah, blah. And you shall name him Jesus.
You're going to have a baby.
You're going to have a baby soon.
What do you think Mary said when she found out she was going to have?
That she was surprised.
What? Are you kidding me?
She did believe the angel.
And do you think the angel told her what kind of baby it was?
No.
A special baby?
Yeah. He asked her.
The angel asked.
He told
her. The angel said,
You will have a baby and you must name him Jesus.
Tomorrow morning.
Yes.
And you must name him Jesus.
Thank
God it.
Second reading, Luke chapter 1, verse 39 through 56, Mary visits Elizabeth. Mary didn't want to waste a minute. She got up and traveled to a town in Judah in the hill country, straight to Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. But Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting. The baby in her womb leaped. She was filled with the Holy Spirit and sang out exuberantly, "You're so blessed among women, and the babe in your womb also blessed. And why I'm so blessed that the mother of my Lord visits me, the moment the sound of your greeting entered my ears, the babe in my womb skipped like a lamb for sheer joy. Blessed women who believe that God said, believed every word it would come true." And Mary said, "Good news, I'm dancing the song of my Savior God. God took one look at me and look what happened. I'm the most fortunate woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. The God whose very name is holy, set apart from all others. His mercy flows in a wave after wave on those who are in awe before him. He bared his arm and showed his strength, scattered the bluffing braggarts. He knocked tyrants off their high horses, pulled victims out of the mud. The starving poor sat down to a banquet. The callous rich were left out in the cold. He embraced his chosen child, Israel. He remembered and piled them high. It's exactly what he promised, beginning with Abraham and right up to now. Mary stayed with Elizabeth for 3 months and then went back to her own home.
Thank you.
Okay, do you guys remember the story about Mary visiting Elizabeth?
No. Yes.
Okay.
Actually, kind of.
What happened there? What happened when Mary went to see Elizabeth?
She saw that she was also having a baby.
I
remember when
Elizabeth
she went to the house,
want to have...
Elizabeth was also pregnant to tell, because she was there to tell her she was having a baby, and then Mary said something, and Elizabeth's baby jumped because it knew what she was talking about. Right?
And wasn't Elizabeth's baby...
The babies were kind of pushing on their tummies. And I didn't remember this because I haven't watched it yet.
Heard Mary's voice.
That's weird.
Third reading, Luke chapter 2, verse 1 through 7, trip to Bethlehem, Jesus' birth. About that time, Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to his own ancestral hometown to be accounted for. So Joseph went from Galilee to Nazareth, up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to let go there, and he went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room in the hotels.
Thank you.
Why did Mary and Joseph have to go to Bethlehem?
Because that's where the dad was from.
Because they had to get registered.
Because they were traveling.
How were they traveling?
By donkey.
By donkey.
Donkey?
Yeah.
By donkey.
Do you know where Jesus was born?
Bethlehem.
In heaven. They went close to the church. They blessed the baby.
Inside.
I thought it was outside.
He was born at a house.
Was it his house or somebody else's?
His.
The farm. Just like to the farm so he could keep the baby warm.
And a hay basket. Okay. Nebraska.
Okay. And?
In the hospital.
We're in no hospitals back then.
Okay.
Hard. This one's a tricky.
A stable, maybe?
In the manger.
Okay, and why in a manger?
Because there was no space in any of the inns. So he had to be in, but innkeeper gave him a little barn.
They made something out of straw for him to sleep in.
Who were his mom and dad? Do you remember?
Mary and Joseph.
Very good. And were they excited when Jesus was born?
Yeah.
How do you suppose they acted? What did they do?
Give him a card. Celebrate.
On Christmas.
The fourth reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 14. There were shepherds camping in the neighborhood, and they had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I am here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everyone worldwide. Savior has just been born in David's town, and a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please him.
To visit after Jesus was born?
The shepherds. How
did the shepherds find out that Jesus had been born?
The big, humongous star, the one that looks like a cross. They're watching.
Watching what?
They're watching in the sky.
And what did they see in the sky?
Jesus came born.
The shepherds heard angels, and
angel came right down and told them.
The shepherds, angels from the sky. That's what they were singing.
Weren't they singing?
They're singing. You put the words in the song.
Okay, so then how did they know where to go? Do you remember?
They just had it on the phone, I guess, maybe?
The fifth reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 15 through 20. As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the sheepherders talked it over. Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us. They left running and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the sheepherders were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear deep within herself. The sheepherders returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they'd been told.
The sixth reading is from Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 2 and 7 through 11. Wise men visit. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem village, Judah territory, this was during Herod's kingship, a band of scholars arrived in Jerusalem from the east. They asked around, "Where can we find and pay homage to the newborn king of the Jews? We observed a star in the eastern sky that signaled his birth. We're on pilgrimage to worship him." Herod then arranged a secret meeting with the scholars from the east. Pretending to be as devout as they were, he got them to tell him exactly when the birth announcement star appeared. Then he told him the prophecy about Bethlehem and said, "Go find this child. Leave no stone unturned. As soon as you find him, send word and I'll join you at once in your worship." Instructed by the king, they set off. Then again the star appeared, the same star they had seen in the eastern skies. It led them on until it hovered over the place of the child. They could hardly contain themselves. They were in the right place. They had arrived at the right time. They entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother. Overcome, they kneeled and worshipped him. Then they opened their luggage and presented gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
To visit while they were in Bethlehem in the stable?
Wise men. The three wise men
and the sheep.
The kings. The kings.
The lepers and the kings.
How did the wise men get to where Jesus was born?
Following the star.
Yeah. The star of Bethlehem.
Angels helped them and they brought him to the place.
They saw a star in the sky and the angels came.
Yeah, they saw a special star and then the angels just came and they told them the rest
of the story. But it actually took a while for them to get there.
Yeah, I think.
Because how did they get there?
Like camels. So it took a while.
Camels or foot?
Camels or foot, but probably camels. So it took a while.
They walked. They found the store.
They rode camels.
They found the store and then they walked there.
They followed the star and rode their camels.
By looking at the North Star.
Looking at the North Star and transported in by camel.
Do you know, what did the wise men bring?
pretty sure one of them was a crown.
And one of them was gold?
Gold?
Silver?
I'm guessing, I think one was some money or like some gold or something.
Something for a king.
Couple?
I think I would give him a bottle. A pass of wire.
He both said bottle at the same time.
And a pacifier?
Yeah.
Okay.
And one of those safety toys that he does.
Oh, yeah. It's
like some type of oil.
Dinosaur?
Okay. Food?
Changes?
All right.
As you find your parents, you can take your worship bag with you. So stop by the front pew and grab your worship bag.
Please stand. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
I invite you to share that greeting of peace with your families and those nearby. With you.
The thrill of hope.
rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn.
Please stand for the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, whom you sent in the fullness of time to be a light to the nations. You scatter the proud in the imagination of their hearts, and have mercy on those who fear you from generation to generation. You put down the mighty from their thrones and exalt those of low degree. You fill the hungry with good things, and the rich you send empty away. Your own Son came among us as a servant to be Emmanuel, your presence with us. He humbled himself in obedience to your will and freely accepted death on the cross. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here and upon these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. And by your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world. Until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. I invite you to join hands with those near you as we pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, you may be seated. Let us rejoice, for Emmanuel shall come to us. Let us share in the feast of salvation. We welcome all to come to the Lord's table to receive the gift of Christ in this meal. There'll be two stations to either side. It'll be a continuous movement of people. Intinction is the method. Take the bread and dip it into the wine, and then receive the bread and wine together. If there are young children who are not communing yet, it helps us to know that who is receiving and who is not if they just bow their heads. And if a child is to receive, the child, if he or she holds out her hand, that will help us. A station in the middle is a gluten-free, for those who need gluten-free bread, and the bread and wine is served at that station for those so desiring.
Do you find it hard to sleep tonight, resting by the Christmas lights? Could there be something you forgot beyond the bow and mistletoe, the tree with presents wrapped below? There's more to this than you had ever thought. Have we lost the reason that we celebrate each year? What is Christmas if
There never was a Savior wrapped in a manger. What is Christmas without Christ? Remember how the story goes. God's gift was wrapped in swaddling clothes. Beneath the star, one great and holy night. The shepherds heard the angels sing. The wise men brought an offering. Peace on earth began in Bethlehem. Have we lost the reason that we celebrate each year? What is Christmas? There never was a Savior wrapped in a manger. What is Christmas if the angels never sang glory to the newborn King? What is Christmas without Christ? There'd be no Gloria in excelsis Deo. What is Christmas if there never was a Savior wrapped in a manger? What is Christmas without Christ? This is Christmas. It's all about a Savior wrapped in a manger. This is Christmas because of Jesus Christ. This is Christmas because of Christ, because of Christ. Thank you.
Please stand. May this body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and preserve you in true faith unto life everlasting. Amen. Together we pray. God, for whom we wait, you come to us in the broken bread and the cup we share. Make us ready always to welcome Christ into our hearts, and send us forth to be your people in the world, announcing your coming among us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Now go, led by the light of Christ Jesus, overflowing with joy because you belong to him, abiding in his peace that casts out all fear, certain of the forgiveness of all your sins, and filled with hope because you are alive with Christ now and for eternity. Amen.
Herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, joy the triumph of the sky. With the angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. By highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, late in time behold him come, offspring of a virgin's womb. Hail in flesh the Godhead see, hail incarnate deity, born to bear with bread to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. The heaven-born Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness, light and light to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Calling lay his glory by, for that we may know may die. Born to raise each child of earth, born to give a second birth.
Now let us go in peace and prepare the way of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.